President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. visits the International Rice Research Institute in Laguna today to look at technologies in improving the agriculture sector. This includes the Agras drone, which can be used to collect data, spray pesticides and fertilizers. The drone also helps reduce the exposure of rice farmers to chemicals. Speaking to the media, Marcos said he wants to strengthen partnerships with the institute. The president also said he will appoint a permanent secretary once he completes his checklist. The Philippines' meat supply slightly drops ahead of the expected surge in demand during the holidays. Our correspondent, Katrina Domingo, now on the line with the details. Katrina?
Hi, Ron. The Philippines' meat supply slightly dipped in the last quarter of 2022. That's according to an official from the Bureau of Animal Industry. According to the Bureau of Animal Industry, as of October 2022, the supply of meat in the Philippines is at 95% sufficiency, lower than the 121% reported in the third quarter of 2022. According to the BAI, despite the slight drop in supply, the Philippines is expected to have adequate meat during the holiday season, when a lot of Filipinos are expected to go out to have dinners and gatherings with family and friends. Aside from the meat supply, Ron, the BAI also guaranteed that the supply of fresh eggs, another in-demand commodity during the holiday season, is stable, with a note that the Philippines has currently 112% sufficiency in eggs. Ron?
Katrina Domingo with that report. Thanks, Kat. Prices of so-called Noche Buena items have jumped from 1% to over 10%. In the past 4 months, that's according to Trade Undersecretary Ruth Castelo. But she says government cannot put a price cap on these items since these products are not considered basic necessities nor prime commodities. The Trade Department instead released a price guide for Noche Buena products. Castelo also warns manufacturers and retailers against profiteering.
Yung mga above 10% kasi profiteering yan, di ba? If the increase is more than 10%, then the prevailing price for the last 3 months, doon papasok ang profiteering. Pero ito kasi, yung nag-increase ng above 10%, nakita naman natin kasi they have been sending advisories to DTI and we have also been requesting data to study presyo ng tin can, presyo ng papel, yung packaging, presyo ng MDM, presyo ng pork na ini-import nila to use doon sa ham product. Ayan, alam natin yung presyuhan talaga in the international market, even logistics kasama at fuel, syempre. So justified naman yung pag-i-increase nila ng presyo.
The ad interim appointment of Migrant Workers Secretary Susan Ople also confirmed. During the hearing, Ople pledged to help migrant workers, saying it is her way to honor and remember the legacy of her late father, former Foreign Affairs Chief Blas Ople. The younger Ople is the first secretary of the Migrant Workers Department, which was created just last year. Meanwhile, the Appointments Commission suspended the discussion on the appointment of Energy Secretary Rafael Otilia due to lack of time. After an initial deferment, the appointment of Gamaliel Cordoba as chairman of the Commission on Audit gets the nod of the Commission on Appointments plenary. During Tuesday's proceedings, Cordoba assured lawmakers of COA's independence under his leadership. Cordoba's term will expire on February 2, 2029.
I would like to assure the honorable members of the Commission on Appointment, pati po ang publiko, na hindi po tayo papayag na magamit or ma-pressure ang ating Commission Audit for any political purposes. So, makakasa po kayo na kami po maging independent. At ang aking pong assurance is I also would go to you for guidance para po sa mga nangyayari po sa aming opisina. Makakaasa po kayo na gagawin po namin ang aming trabaho independently and hindi po maapektuhan ng pressure from any entities.
Cordoba previously served as head of the National Telecommunications Commission under the Duterte administration. It was under his watch when the NTC issued a cease and desist order against ABS-CBN in May 2020.